Hi, good afternoon students. Welcome back to our BS class. How are you? Fine. Okay, very good. I think you fine and stay at home healthy. Okay. Can you study our previous chapter, previous portion? Yes. Okay, very good. Then we are going to discuss about this part 2. Chapter 9, name please. Flower to flower. Chapter 3, flower to flower. Now we are going to discuss about the part 2. Okay, fertilization and pollination. Okay, then. Did you remember this part? This connecting the name a part that connecting to the plant, it is called the producer. Okay, then another one, this part protect the flower and the bud. Okay, it is called the calyx. Okay, then holds the different parts of the flower, name that. Okay, phloemas. Then this part 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts. These are colorful parts. Name this. Yes, corolla. Then this is a this part. Can you say? Yes, androecium. Okay, androecium consists of two parts, filament and anther. Okay, then. This at the tip of this part, this is called the stigma. Okay, you have understood these all parts of a flower. It is all parts of the flowers are different. In what ways they are different? Number of petals, number of sepals, and color, fragrance, shape, size. Okay. This flower, can you see? What flower is? Name Annamada. Okay. Then, now we are discussing about the fertilization. Seed formation. Okay. Then, how can explain the fertilization? First of all, we have to be known male gamete. Male gamete is seen in pollen grains. You know pollen grains, male gamete. Can you see? My yellow color. Can you see? No. And then we can see you. This part is flowering. This part is yellow parts. These are the androecium. This androecium part, it is a anther, consists of pollen grains and filament. Okay. Male gamete is present in pollen grains. This pollen grains reaches the ovary. Male gamete is reaches the ovary to fuse with the egg. It is called the fertilization. Fertilization. Okay. Now we can here all of you listen to me. This picture also. You look. This fertilization. You can see in your textbook after this class, you have to read well and understand this portion, this part. Okay. This is a anther. This, in this pollen, this is a pollen grains. In this, male gamete is present. This male gamete is reaches the ovary. Ovary is the female part. Okay. ovary. Then through this, where can I get? Through this reach here, then fuse with the egg. This process is for the fertilization. Fusion of male gamete with the egg is called the fertilization. Understood now? Then how seed is formed? Then a male gamete from the pollen grains reaches the ovary to and fuse with the egg. Okay, so we can explain this fertilization. Fertilization is very important. Okay, you have to be understand this stigma. Stigma is paragastadam. Okay, and it is a part of the androecium and filaments. Okay, then it is a female part. Female part of the flower is for the gynoecium. Gynoecium consists of ovary, and in ovary egg are present. Okay, so from this picture we have to be understand that where is male gamete seen? In pollen grains. Okay, where is egg is seen in ovary. Okay, where does fertilization takes place? In ovary. Okay, regarding this picture we have understood these questions, simple questions. Okay, then next one, pollen grains. You know, you can see at home you collect the hibiscus flower, then yellow parcel. Okay, then these are the pollen grains. Okay, then next one, these pollens you have seen, maybe you might have seen some living beings, small living beings such as honeybee, some small birds, etc. They will visit the flower. Why do they visit the flower? What for they coming? Why they visit the flower? To drink the nectar. Okay, to drink the nectar from the flower. So this here we can explain the one process, pollination. What is mean by pollination? Transfer of pollens. Yeah, you listen. From this flower, these are the pollens. Transfer pollens to the stigma of a flower. These pollens transfer to the stigma of a flower is called the pollination. Okay, pollination means paragana. Okay, the transfer of a pollen grains from other to the stigma of a flower is called the pollination. Next one, the factors that help in pollination are called the pollinating agents. Pollinating agents are helping to the pollination. How can I explain the pollinating agent? The factors that help in pollination are called the pollinating agents. Okay, understood? Then, now we can watch the pollination by honeybee. Okay, these are the agent, A-N agent. Here, honeybee. Honeybee is from the male gamete from the a flower visited or reach the stigma by the honeybee. Okay, honeybee is a pollinating agent. Under pollinating agents, name some pollinating agents without honeybee. Another pollinating agents, butterfly, small birds, small insects, beetles, small animals like scurus. Okay. How can expel the pollination? How can expel the pollinating agent? Name the pollinating agents. Name the pollinating agent. From beetles, honeybee, small insects, small bats, small animals like scurus, etc. Okay, that. Now you have clear now. Okay, then another one. What are the peculiarities in flower to pollinating by the pollinating agent? എങ്ങനെയാണ് ഈ പോളിനേറ്റിംഗ് ഏജൻസിനെ അട്രാക്ട് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റുന്ന പ്രത്യേകതകൾ പൂക്കളിൽ എന്തൊക്കെയാണ് എന്നാണ് ഇപ്പോൾ മിസ് ചോദിച്ചത്. വാട്ട് പെക്യുലാരിറ്റീസ്? ഫ്ലവേഴ്സ് ഹാവ് ഫ്രാഗ്രൻസ്, ദേ ആർ കളർഫുൾ, ദേ ഹാവ് നെക്ടർ. ഓക്കെ, അതിപ്പോൾ ഫ്ലവേഴ്സ് ആർ സ്മോൾ, വെരി സ്മോൾ. ഓക്കെ, these are very small flowers. Okay, these are seed bunches. Okay, bunches. So if not flowers attraction, other parts of the flower also will be attracted. Okay, so pollinating agents will visit to pollination in flowers. Okay, then what are the peculiarities are seen in flowers to pollinate by the pollinating agents? Name, answer, fragrance. Flowers have, flowers are colorful and have nectar. Another one, small flowers in a bunches. Okay, next one, if not flowers have attraction, the other parts of the flower will be attractive. Okay, these are the important peculiarities of a flower to pollinate by the pollinating agents. Okay, then we have, you might have seen some flowers like this, Landana. Landana is a array. Landana flowers are very small. Very small. In different colors we can see Landana. Landana. Yes. It's a yellow, light rose and orange in violet. Different colors of Landana are seen in our surrounding. Okay. These are the Landana part. These are the small types. Okay. Then here, another one, Mosanda flower. Mosanda flower is a, yes, this. It is a very attractive flower. So it is a small flower. So to attract this flower, other parts of the flower around this flower, some other parts are leaves are white in color. So seeing this white color of these leaves, pollinating agents will be visit this flower. Okay, understood. Another one, bougainvillea. You here. Bougainvillea. This flower, you might have seen this bougainvillea. In these flowers here, these flowers are very small. Can you see very small flowers inside this? Then around this flower here, reddish color change. This part is seen. So pollinating agents are very easy to visit here to pollinate. Okay, understood this? I think this understood this part. Okay, then pollinator flower, Mosanda flower, very very. Okay, then bougainvillea, Landana also have peculiarities. Then another one, paddy flower. What is the peculiarity of the paddy flower? Paddy flower is very small flowers. Okay, paddy flowers are very small flowers. These flowers, in these flowers, Pollen grains are lighter in weight. Okay, lighter in weight. Large number of pollen grains are present in paddy flower. Okay, understood? This flower is fluttering by wind. Okay, fluttering means aadikondirikkya. Okay, nelchedigalla pookale aadikondirikkya. That word is called the fluttering. Okay, so we can explain about this paddy plant, paddy flower. Paddy flower flowers are pollinated by wind. What is the peculiarity of this flower? This flower fluttering due to the wind. Fluttering means aadi kondirikkunna flower. Okay. What are the another peculiarities? Lighter weight. Pollen grains are lighter in weight. They have large number of pollen grains. Okay. Then we have understood that peculiarities of paddy plant. Another important peculiarity of the wheat, sugarcane, maize. Wheat means godamba, chola, maize chola, sugarcane, kandu. These plants also pollinated by the wheat. Okay. So another case is pepper plant. Pollination is done by flies. Okay, water drops. Okay, water drops can be cut. Okay, so we can you might have seen pepper plant. Okay, so here by the wind pollination is taken by in the plants, paddy plants, wheat, sugarcane, maize. And the point in pepper, pollination is taken by the water drops. Okay, then in which season in pepper pollination takes place? In rainy season. Name the season in pepper plant pollination takes place in rainy season. Okay, then another important point, you might have seen elephant young flower. Elephant young flower. What is the peculiarity of this flower? What flower smell will be had? This is the elephant young flower. Chanapur. Okay. From this flower, we feel flower smell. Flower smell means durganda. Okay. So, here pollinating agent is fly. Flies are pollinated in these flowers, such as elephant young flower and taro flower. Taro means chain. Okay, chain. Next one, namely, what are the peculiarities of the flowers? And namely, you have to be match the some pollinating agents. What is this? What are these? We peculiarities are number one, light weight pollen grains in paddy plants. So we have to be matching the which pollinating agent? Yes, wind. Okay. Next one, colorful flowers pollinating agent name. Okay, honeybee. Next one, white flowers that bloom at weight. For example, jasmine. That pollinating agent is moth. Moth means yamat. Okay. Next one, pollination in moisture. Pollination in moisture means moisture air pump. So, water drops. Then, now you listen here. Features of flowers and pollinating agents. Okay. Lightweight pollen grains by the wind. Colored flowers, pollinated agent honeybee. White flowers start to bloom at night. Moth. Next one. Pollination in moisture. Water drops or dew drops. Okay. Below here inside a box set, these pairs are given. So we have to select the pollinating agents. Okay. Then next one. Next one. Artificial pollination. Different than artificial pollination, we have discussed now pollination. Transfer of pollen grains from another to the stigma is called the pollination. Okay, transfer of pollen grains to the stigma of a flower is called the pollination. Then, in the case of artificial pollination, pollen grains from a superior quality seeds collected and dusted on a stigma of a other plants is called the artificial pollination. Okay. Artificial pollination is Kruthrima Paragamam. Okay. First of all, pollen grains from superior quality seeds collected and dusted on a stigma of other flower is called the artificial pollination. Okay, here name A, honeybee, melipona. Melipona is a another pollinating agent in vanilla. Here, vanilla, in our country, vanilla. Artificial pollination is done by man in vanilla flower. Okay, then next step, we can discuss about the journey of pollen grains. Pollen grains, journey of pollen grains, yatra. Here we have to understand pollen grains from pumpkin flower transfer to the stigma of a Asgard flower. It is not affected. Okay. In the case of pollen grains from Asgard flower to the stigma of same Asgard flower is very effective. Okay, so we have to be understanding that same flowers. Okay, differently. Yeah, pollen grains of pumpkin flower falling to the stigma of Asgard flower is not effective, but pollen grains of Asgard falling on the stigma of Asgard is very effective. Okay, you have to be understood that well. Okay, that and that we can we can explain about these two types of pollination: self pollination and cross pollination. How can explain them? Then we can take here this plant. It is a hibiscus plant. Okay. Here it is a pollen here present. Can you see this? Here pollen grains are present. From these pollen grains, male gamete is reaches here stigma. Stigma is paragonstem. Okay. So this type of pollination is called the self-pollination. Okay. In same plant, in same flower, male gamete from the pollen grains transferred to the stigma of a same flower is called the self-pollination. Okay. Now you ask this. Okay, first picture you look one flower pad, then here male gamete reaches this stigma. Okay, so this type of pollination is called the self-pollination. And then next other type of self-pollination. Okay, we can here it is a almanda flower plant. Okay, same same plant. Flower, same plant has two flower. Then from a flower, male gamete transfer to the another flower sigma. Okay, this type of the pollination is also called the self-pollination. Okay, you listen please. Now what? Okay, same plant. In a plant, two flowers are seen. From these pollen grains, male gamete is transferred to the sigma of a another flower. It is called the self-pollination. Another type of the self-pollination. Okay, then cross pollination. Cross pollination means, okay, two hibiscus flower separated plants. Okay, then from this flower pollen in the pollen grains, male gamete is transferred to this another flower of the plant. Is called the cross pollination. Okay, cross pollination. You can understand from this picture. There are two hibiscus plant in separate plant. Flowers are seen separately. So from this flower, for male gamete is transferred to the at this stigma of a another plant. Okay, this type of the pollination is called the cross pollination. Okay, from this another of transfer of pollen from another of a flower to the sigma of the same flower is called the self pollination, and transfer of pollen grains from the separate flowers in a separate flower planting is called the self cross pollination. Okay, then you have to be read well our textbook. Okay, then watch this picture and understand from our textbook. Then in this portion, in this part, we have explained about these flowers peculiarities, pollination, two types of pollination, self pollination and cross pollination and pollinating agents. Except. Okay, today have a nice day. Today we can conclude our this class. Then next class we can see again. Okay, thank you.